Good morning, I'm Eric Scott. This is New Jersey's First News for Tuesday, June 21st. Welcome to the first official day of summer. Although it won't feel very summer-like today, our chief meteorologist Dan Zero says we could see a passing shower at any point today, and then heavier, steadier rain is on the way for tonight. How long is that going to last? Full forecast details are available on air, online at nj1015.com, and on our free mobile app. New Jersey has its first confirmed case of the rare monkeypox virus. State health officials confirming the infected individual is from North Jersey, now self-isolating. Contact tracing is being performed to determine who else may have been exposed. Monkeypox has now been identified in 20 states and the District of Columbia. It can be spread through close, prolonged contact with an infected person or an animal. The steady decline of gas prices continues this morning. Here are the latest numbers from AAA. The statewide average down 2 cents a gallon, $4.97. That's an 8 cent drop in a week, but still 20 cents higher than a month ago. With the exception of the Route 1 corridor, average prices have fallen below $5 in all counties. Somerset's still expensive at $5.12 a gallon. That's tops in the state. Prices have been adjusted at Turnpike and Parkway rest stops. They are now at $5.09 a gallon for regular. Firefighters continue to battle that stubborn forest fire at Wharton State Forest this morning. The good news, 70% contained, according to the Forest Fire Service. 12,000 acres have been burned. The fire initially was small in size, but fueled by dry and breezy conditions, it began spreading quickly Sunday night. Now, the winds are shifting, so more of the Garden State may notice a smoky smell, and the haze may also spread. We're also monitoring for air quality alerts. We'll keep you updated on air and online at nj1015.com. A Somerset County School District is going to have an armed police presence through the end of the year. Next year, however, that is still a big question mark. Bridgewater Raritan Superintendent Robert Beers says he found out Monday morning with the public the district would have cops with guns as security through Thursday. Beers says the mayor told him that it was due to more visitors and events surrounding graduations. Despite vocal opposition, the borough of Fairlawn will go on with its LGBTQ Pride Festival scheduled for this Sunday. And while some people were upset over the idea of the block party, the most vocal controversy surrounded what's known as Drag Queen Story Hour. It's billed as an activity to promote literacy and tolerance. It features a drag queen reading books to kids. Mayor Kurt Peluso says they're prepared for protests of the event, but the celebration of Pride Month will continue. When will the ramp from Route 287 North to Route 78 East reopen? That's a good question after a big sinkhole consumed a big chunk of that roadway. The ramp from northbound 287 to eastbound 78 will remain closed indefinitely, we're being told now. The crater takes up the right shoulder and a chunk of the right lane. Now, engineers have evaluated the hole to come up with a repair plan, but so far they haven't given any indication of how long that repair is going to take. There is a pet food recall to tell you about this morning. Fresh Pet, fresh from the kitchen chicken could have salmonella. Only the 4.5-pound bags sold at Target and Walmart have been recalled. They have an October 29th sell-by date. There have been no reports of pets actually falling ill. In an alarming trend, another bear sighting, this time on a South Jersey golf course. The bear seen Sunday near the Atlantis course in Little Egg Harbor. It's not exactly known what time of day or where on the course the bear was seen. These screenshots from video posted on Facebook by police seem to indicate the bear could have been wandering through Deerbrook Drive early yesterday morning. New Jersey is now approaching 500 bear sightings this year across the state. Is your town growing or shrinking? Our Mike Simons is taking a closer look at census data and where New Jersey is losing and gaining population. More than half of all towns in our state, smaller today than they were in 2020. You can check out his full list of towns at nj1015.com. If you have something to say about our top stories, leave your comments right here. Please like and share this video. And remember, we're always taking your calls talking Jersey on air on New Jersey 101.5. I'm Eric Scott. That's New Jersey's First News for this Tuesday, June 21st. Have a great day.